So in this video, we're going to actually create now your channel art for YouTube. So for that, over here is the channel art and there is no size mentioned. So either you can go over here, which is the pencil mark. Once you are logged in, click on that. You will have edit channel art and you will have the recommended size right over here. 2560 cross 1440 and maximum file size is 6 MB. You can either go here or the place where I'm actually going to show you how to create your channel art absolutely for free. You don't have to pay a single dime. That particular software is known as Canva. It's basically a website, canva.com. Most of the people know it. So people who have no money to invest in high paid softwares or mobile apps, they can obviously go with canva.com, and that is what I'm going to actually show it to you. So canva.com is the one with which I've created a lot of designs. Now, if you can see digitalmarketingforfree.com, that's the blog which I have and on which I am blogging related to digital marketing. So let's just open up that. And if you can see, there is digital marketing for free, this upper line, all right, the header section. Now, a couple of people might think that it's a text, but it's actually an image which I have created right over here, right? If you can see. So you can create a hell lot of things in canva.com for free, provided you have your creativity. So once you are over here, what you have to do is use custom designs, click on that. You'll have your width and pixels. So basically, if you know the size, you can enter over here, or let's say don't use custom dimensions and you click on more right over here and you see this YouTube channel art. Now that's the popular design type. If you don't see it over here, you can see it inside your social media posts or somewhere down, all right? Somewhere you'll see YouTube channel art, social media and email headers. So that's the same size, 2560 pixels cross 1440 pixels. So let's click on that. And we'll have the predefined size for us, the template. Now right over here, you have Canva layouts, out of which a couple of them are free. It's mentioned free. So what you can do is simply, let's say you click on that and you can actually select this template and make changes by selecting on that, tapping on that, and typing text, changing the images, such kind of things. Now let's assume that if you don't see anything free, then do you have to pay money? No, not at all. You pay money, and for every little thing, you pay $1 over here most of the times. So you don't have to pay $1 for this. What you can do is, let's delete this. Let's delete the template, or let's add a new page. All right, and now let's delete this. So in this, I want this paid template. If you can see, when you move your cursor, you'll see dollar sign, or you don't see the free sign, basically. So once you click on that, you'll have this. And if you want it for free, there would be inside the background the watermark of Canva. Now, if you want to remove it, when you click on download, and when you click on download once again, it will ask you to remove the marker. So let's say before and after is this. So got it. Once you click on say, it will ask you to pay the money. All right, $1. So you pay $1 for every little design. But let's say you don't want this. So what you can do is you can simply click on the image and you can click on delete. And now I'll show you how to get free photo stock photography. All right. And there is a website, or there are a lot of websites, out of which one is unsplash.com. Then you have Pixel, I spelled it wrong, Pixel, all right, Pixel, pixels.com. These are the two which are frequently being used, but there are a lot of them. You can actually go to gauravmadan.com, where he has actually written 300 plus. Yeah, this is the article which I'm talking about. And in this one, you have somewhere free stock photography. Yeah, this is the one. So free stock photography. This is the one. So you have stock up, you have pixels, You have all the free stock, Unsplash, Splash Base, Startup Stock Photos, Jai Mantri, Movies, Travel Coffee Book, Designer Picks. So all these are websites just like these ones which I have opened up, Unsplash and Free Stock. So what you can basically do over here is you can choose any one of them out of this. So let's say if I type something like social media over here. Social media and digital marketing. I want to select one of the image which I can use for our cover pic. Let's say this one. Now, once you have got the image, once you like it, you can click on download and it will start downloading. And this is completely for free. You have the license, right? So these are known as free stock photos. So you can get all of these websites right over here. I'll put up the link somewhere around this video so you can get it absolutely for free. And then once you have downloaded that, you can come back to Canva and you can select this area, click on this, and you can click on uploads, upload your image and upload the same which you had just downloaded. And once it is there, you can simply click on this and the image will be coming over here. And you can drag like this. And drag, move here and there, and it will automatically fit behind the text. All right, once you drag it completely with the size, it will automatically be there in the background. Now what you can do is you can actually put up some layout, or you can say elements. Let's go into elements and I'll go into shapes. I'll go with the first one and let's say I put this as the entire thing. Basically, I want to darken, or I want to have an overlay on the image which is there in the background. Now let's click on arrange for this. Let's say back. All right. So now I have this. Now let's once again click on the black portion. And let's click on this and let's say transparency to this one. Let's change the text and what's our channel name? Let's resemble that. Pratik Sinchurasma. I'll simply write digital Pratik. Let's say digital Pratik. Digital Pratik. Let's reduce the spacing, letter spacing. All right. All right, 80. This is fine. Let's move this a little bit. Digital Pratik, learn. Apply and share. This is how I'm going to write, but let's say, oh, YouTuber. Yep, that's fine. Digital Pratik, YouTuber. Let's move this a little bit. And I'm okay with this design as of now, right? So once you have done, click on download. Most of the times, if you get, try to get it PNG format, or you can go for JPEG. All right, JPG. So I'll say PNG, I'll say download. And And now it has downloaded right over here. Let's go back to our channel. Let's click on edit channel art. Select photo from computer. Let's select this. Now assume that your image which you have created is higher than 6 MB in size. All right, higher than 6 MB in size, then what you can do is you can actually go to a website which is known as compressor.io. Right, you can visit compressor.io/compress. Right over here, what you can do is you can select your file. If it is larger than 6 MB, you can select the file. Let's say I select the same image, 2.9 MB. So let's see if we can compress the size for 2.9 MB as well or not. So as soon as you upload, it will automatically compress. You don't have to do anything. You simply have to upload your image at compressor.io. And once it is uploaded, it will start compressing and it will give you the image size as well. So 2.94 MB has become 864.43 KB only, right? 71% reduction. And then you can download this file and you can straight away upload that one. This was like for images which were greater than 6 MB. For us, it was 2.9 MB, so we are good to go. And once you upload your image, you see three different sizes or three different examples. Desktop, how it will look like on desktop, how it will look like when people are watching your YouTube channel on TV, and how it will look like when it is on mobile. Now see, when they are looking on mobile, it is cropping my D and K at the end, right? So you have to take care of this. So once again, I'll go back to Canva and let's say what I'll do is I'll reduce the size for this one from 66 to let's say 50. Let's do the same for this one, 50. Let's move this a little bit on this side. Let's take this line up. Let's reduce the size for this to 15. Let's move this a little bit up. Now I guess it should take the size. Make sure whenever you are creating your YouTube channel art, you keep your text, most of your text which you want to display, try to keep it in the center of the image so that you don't have to play around with the cropping. Automatically your image would be in the center and it would fit in all the devices. So now I have this, let's download once again. And let's go back to our channel. Let's say, how do we change? All right, I'll say cancel, edit channel art, select the photo. So the size has increased actually. It became 3 MB from 2.9. Anyways, so now let's see if it is looking good. Yes, it is looking good. Obviously, if it was my running channel, live channel, I wouldn't go for this kind of image obviously because it's very plain and simple. I actually like plain and simple, but this is not that good which I wanted, right? But just for demonstration purpose, you can play around. This is not an editing course, it's for YouTube SEO. But just because for YouTube SEO you need to have an channel art which is super important in terms of YouTube and Google, so make sure you have a good channel art over here. And you can adjust the crop over here if you're not satisfied. So let's say I move this, I move like this, and I say devices preview, so it is in center once again. Let's see what happens when you click on auto enhance. So basically they'll just change the brightness and all sorts kind of things. Let's select this and let's see how it is looking on our YouTube channel. All right, so we have our channel art right over here. Now let's say how you can change your channel icon. If you click on this, it will say your channel icon comes from your Google account. Changes may take a few minutes to show on your channel. When you click on edit, it will redirect and it will open up on a new tab, your Google about me. All right, if you want to upload, you can upload a picture. So let's say I click on upload. I'll upload any of my images. let's say this one. Let's click on done. And that image has come right over here, right? But when you close this tab and when you refresh your YouTube channel, it might not show the image instantly, right? The image won't show instantly. It might take some time, maybe 24 hours, up to 24 hours. And once they have updated, it will come over here, the same image, right? And that's the reason why before you upload, they say that it might take time for your edits to change, to take place on your YouTube channel. All right, so that's how, because let's say if you click on that pencil icon, and once again, you, if you go over here, you are obviously seeing the image right over here, but you won't see that on YouTube channel. So it will take time, right? So I'll see you in the next video.